Yes friends, welcome once again to the class and welcome once again to the channel, and we are going to learn about nuclear isomerism in today's class, which is an important concept as far as your UPSC CSE physics optional exam is concerned. Okay, so as far as your UPSC CSE physics optional exam is concerned, in the paper 2 nuclear and particle physics, this particular topic nuclear isomerism is also important, and it is taught in very few coachings around this country. The nuclear and particle physics, this particular concept nuclear isomerism, is taught in very less coachings, okay, very few coachings actually. So we are going to learn about nuclear isomerism today, and that too in detail. Although the nuclear isomerism, only 10 marks worth question will be asked in the examination, okay. Please remember that in UPSC physics optional, only 10 marks worth question will be asked out of this particular topic nuclear isomerism, okay. So let us see. Nuclear isomers are atoms with the same mass number and atomic number. Okay, so the mass number of nuclear isomers is same, and atomic number is also the same. Okay, so nuclear isomers are atoms with same mass number and atomic number, that is Z is same and mass number is also same. Now what is the difference if atomic number is also the same and mass number is also the same? And please do not get confused by the word atoms over here. Okay, I am using the word atom over here because of this particular reason. Because of this particular reason, I am using the word atom over there. The thing is, this is your nucleus, okay, and these are the various shells in which the electrons are revolving. Now, right now, do not go into the concept of quantum mechanics, which says that electrons actually do not revolve around the nucleus. Okay, please do not go into that particular concept right now. Just consider whatever I am saying for the time being. Okay, just consider whatever I am saying for the time being. I will make it even more clearer to you in the upcoming segment of this particular lecture. So suppose this particular nuclear atom. Okay, what are nuclear isomers? I am telling you, this is atom number 1, suppose you are, and this is suppose your atom number 2. What are nuclear isomers? That is the thing which I am going to discuss right now. Okay, so in this atom number 1, suppose there are electrons outside in these all shells, there are electrons, and in all these shells there are electrons. Okay, in this particular atom 2 also. Now in this particular atom number 1, all the outer things, okay, whatever things are outside this particular nucleus, over here we have nucleus, right? Over here we have nucleus, okay, and over here also we have nucleus. So we have nucleus with us, okay. Now the outer shell, okay, these are what? These are all outer shell of electrons. These are what? These are outer shell of electrons. These are outer shell of electrons. These are all outer shell of electrons. Now have a look at atom number 1 and atom number 2. What is the difference between, and these two are suppose nuclear isomers. These two are what? These two are nuclear isomers. Suppose. So what is the difference between these two atoms then? See, the blue colored region. The blue colored region is the same for both these. Okay. The region which is blue in color. The blue colored region is same for both these atoms. Okay. But this green colored region will be different. This green colored region, the green colored region, that is the nucleus, will be different. Okay, different. Now how it is different? How it is different? The thing is the number of protons will also be same. The number of neutrons will also be same. Okay, but the nuclear configuration, okay, the number of protons and neutrons are the same. The atomic mass number A, that is number of protons plus number of neutrons, that is also going to be the same. Okay, that is also going to be the same. But what is the thing? The nuclear configuration is going to be different. Okay, the nuclear configuration is going to be different for both these atoms. Okay, so the atom comprises of the outer shell of electrons and a nucleus. So in the nucleus also everything is same except the nuclear configuration. Okay, in the nucleus also everything is same except the nuclear configuration. So if the nuclear configuration for both the atoms differ, okay, if the nuclear configuration of the nucleus, okay, just listen to it very properly, okay, if the nuclear configuration of the nucleus of the two atoms, okay, if the nuclear configuration of the nuclei, okay, let me mark it properly, if the nuclear configuration of the nuclei of the two atoms, okay, differ, if the nuclear configuration of the nuclei of the two atoms differ, then they are called as nuclear isomers. This is the thing you must remember. Okay, now, nuclear isomers are atoms with the same mass number and atomic number but with different states of excitation in the atomic nucleus. Okay, so nuclear isomers are actually atoms. Okay, why are we calling them atoms? Because the nucleus cannot exist in isolation. The nucleus cannot exist in isolation ever in this universe. Okay, or on this particular planet Earth, forget the universe. In the universe, in supernova, in universe we have various things like supernova, pulsar, okay, neutron atom, neutron star, white giant, black dwarf, etc., etc., white dwarf, okay, neutrino star, various things we have, okay, nebula, various things we have in the universe. In those things, of the universe, nucleus can exist in isolation without electrons, okay, but on earth under normal circumstances, on this particular planet Earth, under normal circumstances, this nucleus cannot remain in isolation. This particular nucleus, that is the green colored region, that is the nucleus, it cannot remain in isolation. It will be always surrounded with revolving electrons. It will be always surrounded by revolving electrons. Now, I have already told you that it is wrong to say that it will be surrounded by revolving electrons. Okay, the nucleus will be surrounded by revolving electrons. It is wrong to say so. Why it is wrong to say so? Because quantum mechanics has clearly told us that electrons do not revolve around the nucleus. Quantum mechanics has clearly told us that electrons actually do not revolve around the nucleus. Okay, actually electrons exist in the form of electron clouds. Okay, Around the nucleus, electrons exist in the form of electron clouds. Okay, electrons exist outside the nucleus in the form of electron clouds, not in the form of revolution or rotation or such things. Okay, so quantum mechanics has clearly told this, that electron exists in the form of electron cloud instead of revolving around the nucleus. It was the Rutherford theory which used to say so. That electrons are revolving, but it has been proved wrong. You have already learnt in quantum mechanics that it has been already proved wrong that electrons are revolving around the nucleus. This particular fact has already been proved wrong. Okay. Now, so why have I used the term atom over here? The thing is that the nucleus will exist in the form of atom. Okay. So always the nucleus will be accompanied by electrons. That's what I mean. The nucleus will be accompanied by electrons around it. Okay, so the nucleus will be accompanied by electrons around it. That's why we have used the term atoms over here. Okay, you can use the term nuclei also. Nuclear isomers are nuclei with same mass number and atomic number. You can use nuclei also. in the place of atoms, if you use the term nuclei over here, okay, if you use the term nuclei over here, it is also one and the same thing. Okay, why it is one and the same thing? Because the difference is in the nuclear configuration only. The difference is there in nuclear configuration only. Atom, I have used the term atom over here just to show you that the nucleus will not exist in isolation. It will always be accompanied by the electrons. In order to show that, I have used the term atoms over here. But in reality, it will be in the form of atom only, not in the form of isolated nuclei. But still, you can use the term nuclei also over here. So nuclear isomers are nuclei with the same mass number and atomic number, but with different state of excitation in the atomic nucleus. Okay, so but different states of excitation will be there in the atomic nucleus. Now let me give you one example. Okay, let me give you one example. Now suppose I have Na 1123, sodium 1123, and I have sodium 1123 once again. Okay, so let me draw the sodium, okay, structure which we used to draw in the lower classes. So what did we draw in the lower classes? Let us see. So over here we have two electrons, okay, then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 electrons over here. Okay, and what do we have next? We have one electron in the outermost. Okay, so similarly, these two are suppose nuclear isomers. Okay, these two are suppose nuclear isomers. So what will happen in that particular case? That's what I am telling you. Okay. Now, in this particular thing also, the same thing is going to happen. Okay. But this particular nucleus, the red colored nucleus, is different. This red colored nucleus is different from this blue colored nucleus. This red colored nucleus is different from this blue colored nucleus, and I am going to explain it in very detail to you. Okay, so just a second, friends. So this and this, okay, then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, we have this, and then what do we have? Okay, so this complete region which I am going to talk about right now, this complete region is identical in both. Okay, this complete region. And this complete region, that is the region where electrons reside. This particular region is same in both these nuclear isomers. This particular region is same. Now, where is the difference? Okay. So suppose in this particular red colored nucleus, we have these are the nuclear energy levels, okay, in this red colored, and similarly in this blue colored nucleus also we have various energy levels, okay, 1, 2, and 3. So suppose we are talking about 11 protons, okay, 11 protons we are talking about. So the 11 protons will go like this. Okay, suppose I am saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I am giving you just an hypothetical example. Okay, and 1, 2, 3, फोर फाइव ओके सो 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 सो 11 प्रोटॉन्स हैव बीन फिल्ड अप लाइक दिस सपोज आई एम सेइंग इट इज जस्ट एन अजम्पशन ओके जस्ट एन हाइपोथेटिकल एग्जांपल आई एम गिविंग यू इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सप्लेन यू दैट व्हाट डज इट मीन बाय न्यूक्लियर आइसोमर्स ओके सो 11 प्रोटॉन्स हैव बीन फिल्ड अप ओवर हियर व्हाट हैज बीन डन इज दैट 11 प्रोटॉन्स हैव बीन फिल्ड अप ओवर हियर ओके नाउ इन दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूक्लियस 1 2 3 4 ओके सो वी हैव फोर एनर्जी लेवल्स नाउ हाउ विल द न्यूक्लियॉन्स दैट इज द 11 प्रोटॉन्स हाउ विल इट इट ऑल्सो हैज 11 प्रोटॉन्स ओनली दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूक्लियस ऑल्सो हैज 11 प्रोटॉन्स ओनली बट द न्यूक्लियर कॉन्फिग्रेशन विल बी डिफरेंट ओके सो सपोज वी हैव 2 ओवर हियर वी हैव 3 ओवर हियर ओके वी हैव 1 ओवर हियर एंड वी हैव 1 2 3 4 5 ओवर हियर ओके सो यू कैन सी दैट द न्यूक्लियर कॉन्फिग्रेशन फॉर बोथ ऑफ देम इज डिफरेंट ओके although both of them have 11 protons although both of them have 11 protons 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 and 11 11 protons right and over here also if you count 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 so it also has 11 protons only similarly the number of neutrons are also the same similarly the number of neutrons are also the same in both but in this particular blue colored nucleus in this particular blue colored nucleus this second shell has 3 protons okay in this blue colored nucleus second shell has 3 protons but in this red colored nucleus the second shell has 2 protons only okay so it had 3 protons in the second shell this blue colored nucleus had 3 protons in the second shell okay but this blue colored nucleus had 3 protons in the second shell but this red colored nucleus only has 2 protons in the second shell this red colored nucleus has 3 protons in the first shell okay this red colored nucleus has 3 protons in the first shell that is the first energy level but this blue colored nucleus only has 2 protons in the first energy level okay so this is the thing which is there so you got the difference between the two the what does it mean by nuclear isomers you got the difference hopefully so nuclear isomers are atoms that are nuclei with the same mass number and atomic number but with different states of excitation different states of excitation means the nuclear configuration is going to be different how to write the nuclear configuration you have already learned right how to write the nuclear configuration of any nucleus this particular fact you have already learned in the nuclear shell model right in the nuclear shell model you have already learned how to write the nuclear configuration of any nucleus you have already learned in the nuclear shell model okay so different state of excitation in the atomic nucleus the so the state of excitation of in the atomic nucleus will be different that is the nuclear configuration of the two nuclei the nuclear configuration of the two atomic nuclei the nuclear configuration of the two atomic nuclei why are we calling them atomic nuclei because they are the nucleus of the atom okay we are calling them atomic nuclei because they are nucleus of the atom that's why we are calling them atomic nuclei they will exist in the form of atom they will not exist in the form of isolated nucleus they will exist in the form of atom they will not exist in the form of isolated nucleus that's why we are using this particular term okay so are atoms with same mass number atom and atomic number but different states of excitation in the atomic nucleus the higher or more excited state is called a metastable state okay the higher or more excited state okay you already know about what is ground state and excited state let me tell you the difference between ground state and excited state okay let me tell you the difference between ground state and excited state let me make it very clear to you the thing is ground state okay ground state is such a thing which exists in nature by default okay ground state is the actually lowest possible state okay not existing in nature by default my apologies my concept is that the ground state is such a state of the nucleus which exists okay विच इज द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ लोवेस्ट पॉसिबल एनर्जी लेवल. ग्राउंड स्टेट इज द लोवेस्ट पॉसिबल स्टेट ऑफ एनी न्यूक्लियस. ओके, व्हेन यू राइट द न्यूक्लियर कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ एनी न्यूक्लियस, द लोवेस्ट पॉसिबल एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम, ओके, द लोवेस्ट पॉसिबल द एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम विथ लोवेस्ट पॉसिबल एनर्जी, ओके, द एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम विथ लोवेस्ट पॉसिबल एनर्जी, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द ग्राउंड स्टेट ऑफ एनी न्यूक्लियस. ओके, द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूक्लियर शेल मॉडल, लेट मी रिपीट इट, द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम, ओके, द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम ऑफ एनी न्यूक्लियस, द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम ऑफ एनी न्यूक्लियस अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूक्लियर शेल मॉडल, द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी लेवल डायग्राम ऑफ एनी न्यूक्लियस अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूक्लियर शेल मॉडल, when the neutrons and protons all are filled, when the neutrons and protons are filled in those subshells, when the neutrons and protons are filled in those subshells, such that it is the lowest possible energy state, then such a state is called as ground state. Okay, so you will have various energy levels, and when you fill the neutrons and protons, you will obtain some kind of energy associated with each of the proton and neutron residing in each subshell. So when it is the lowest possible energy state, it is called as ground state. Okay, when it is the lowest possible energy state, then it is called as ground state. Okay, ground state has no relation to whether it is existing in nature or not. Okay, let me make this very clear to you. Ground state has no relation to whether it is existing in nature, or whether sometimes the excited state are existing in nature in abundance. Okay, sometimes instead of ground state the excited states are existing in nature in abundance instead of ground state, sometimes I am saying. Okay, so it is not necessary that the ground state nuclear configuration will be in abundance always. Okay, it might be in abundance or it might be in minority, but the ground state is such a state where the nuclear configuration is written in such a way that it is the lowest possible energy of the nucleus. Okay, that is when you calculate the energy of the nucleus will be lowest in that particular state. And that particular state is called as ground state. Okay, so you hopefully got the meaning of ground state. The higher or more excited state is called the metastable state, where while the stable unexcited state, okay, the more excited state is what? Higher or more excited state is called metastable state. Okay. Now, what does it mean by metastable state? We are going to learn. This particular concept we are going to learn in the next class. Okay. But for the time being, just understand what is the meaning of ground state. So the higher or more excited state is called as metastable state, while the stable unexcited state is called as the ground state. Although the ground state is stable and unexcited, it has the lowest possible energy. Ground state is stable, unexcited, and has the lowest possible energy. Okay, it is stable. Ground state is stable, unexcited, and has the lowest possible energy. Still, sometimes ground state might be in minority. Okay, although it is stable and unexcited state, still it might be in minority in some of the cases. Okay, in some of the nuclear isomers. Okay, so we will talk about it later, but for the time being, just understand the meaning of ground state. Ground state is the stable unexcited state with the lowest possible energy. It is called as ground state. And more excited state or higher or more excited state is called as what? Metastable state. Higher or more excited state is what? It is called as metastable state. Okay. And what does it mean by metastable state? We are going to learn. Okay, what is the difference between excited state and metastable state? okay, what is the difference between excited state and metastable state, that also we are going to learn, but in the upcoming class. In the upcoming class, we are going to learn what is metastable state and what is what is metastable state and what is excited state, and when is an excited state called as a metastable state. We are going to learn all those things, okay? But for the time being, hopefully the definition of nuclear isomer is very clear to you. For the time being, whatever I wanted to explain you the definition of nuclear isomer, but hopefully the definition of nuclear isomer is very clear to you, okay, right now. So hopefully it is very clear to you. So the higher excited state is called as metastable state, while the stable unexcited state is called as the ground state. Now what is metastable state, we are going to see. I have already written over here that what is metastable state and what is the difference between metastable state and excited state. All those things we are going to learn. But in the upcoming class, okay, from here onwards the theory starts, okay. So in this particular lecture, we have understood the definition of nuclear isomer. In this particular lecture, what have we done? We have actually learned the definition of nuclear isomer. And that's all for today's lecture. Okay. Next lecture will be tomorrow. But hopefully the definition of nuclear isomer is very clear to you. Okay. And 10 marks worth question. A question worth 10 marks will be asked to you. A question worth 10 marks based on nuclear isomerism. A question worth 10 marks based on nuclear isomerism might be asked to you in your examination. Okay. So you must be very aware of that. Very much aware of that. Okay. So thank you very much.